خلاص
هي خلاص
زين جمال خلاص. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، فيا أيها الأحبة في الله، إن الله خلقنا جل وعلا لحكمة بليغة، كما قال ربنا تبارك وتعالى: وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. Oh my beloved brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all. Allah has created us for a greater wisdom and purpose. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, I have not created the jinn and mankind except to worship me, except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمْ يَخْلُقْنَا عَبَثًا. Allah never created us. Allah never created us without any purpose. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. فتعالى الله الملك الحق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the meaning of the verse. Do you think we have created you without any purpose, without any wisdom? فتعالى الله الملك الحق. Far away Allah from imperfection. Far away for Allah from imperfection. For Allah to create the creation without any purpose, that is imperfection. وَالْعِيَّادُ بِاللَّهِ. Rather, Allah create us for a purpose. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in His noble book. And there is other wisdoms for Allah creating the creation. One of them, in order for us to worship Him. And Allah is not in need of our worship. Allah is not in need of our worship. We are in need of worshiping Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. What is the other purposes that Allah create us for? نعم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وهو العزيز الغفور. As a test, to test us. And in order for Allah to test us, لوك تدوز الله سبحانه وتعالى. التست هاز تو بي ذا تست هاز تو اوكر باي واي اوف جود اند وات ايفل اند باد. بارك الله فيك ما شاء الله عبد الله. Good and bad. That shows the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the second one. What is the other purpose? What is the other purpose for Allah creating the creation? That's why with the atheist struggles to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not struggles, because believing Allah is something which is well-rooted. Keep deceiving yourself, lying to yourself. There is not enough proofs and evidence for Allah's existence. That is a pure lie. Kidding. That's your nafs al-ammara bisu, is lying to you, deceiving you. This is the reality. Believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not something which is nadari, theory. You have to, you know, look for proofs and no. It's something which is well-rooted within us. Na'am, you need a reminder, yes. But you don't need to teach, because it's something which is well-rooted. What is the other purpose for Allah creating us? Ali, tfadal. نعم. To implement his names and attributes سبحانه وتعالى. طيب, what is the other purpose? There's four ulama mentioned. To recognize one another. To recognize one another. So my dear brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all. All of us, we are in need of a reminder. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام من هديه, from his guidance and from his teaching, he used to give a reminder to his companions. Because all of us, sometimes we forget, you know, we become heedless about this dunya and the reality of this dunya. And subhanallah, Surah Al-Dhariyat, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. In it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, ففروا إلى الله. Flee to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. There is no salvation and there is no success and there is no security and safety in this life. Likewise in the hereafter, except by fleeing to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and turning back to Allah تبارك وتعالى. لا ملجأ ولا منجا منك إلا إليك. طيب, to worship him, test us, to implement his name's attributes, to recognize one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, see, you made me forget that I lost my train of thoughts. Na'am. Brothers, can you come forward, please? Barakallahu feekum. Na'am. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa al-Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam used to say, لا ملجأ ولا منجا إلا إليك. There is no safety and escape except by turning back to you, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because my dear brothers and sisters, our own existence is by the virtue of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We are by default, we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's our nature. We are in need of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And from Allah's nature, that is a self-sufficient. Subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of nothing. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and my sisters, from Allah's mercy and Allah's favor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. We show him the correct way. Either the person is grateful or ungrateful. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never left us to our own feelings and our ways to come to conclusion how to fight or how to fight back against the evil things in this life. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us guidance through his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And subhanallah, as one of the ulama mentioned, when you go to universities or colleges or schools, and they give you a test, they will never give you the answer for the test. They don't give you the answer. Allah gave you the test and he gave you what? The answer. That's why from foolishness and stupidity of some people, they say, what, Allah is going to punish the kafir in Jahannam forever? Because Allah showed him everything. And this person is stubborn. He chose disbelief and arrogance and belittling his creator. That's why he deserves Jahannam forever. So the question you should not ask, why Allah is going to punish the kafir in Jahannam forever? The question you should ask, why are you kafir want to go to Jahannam forever? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna hadaynahu sabila imma shakir wa imma kafura. Allah showed him the way, the correct way to, in order to follow it, and the evil way in order to stay away from it. That's why in the Quran is hidayah, guidance, clarifying to us the reality of this life, and that this life is a test. And you have an enemy, we have an enemy that is a shaitan. And in order for us to save ourselves from the deception of a shaitan is by turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fafirru ila Allah. Flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawheed, prayer, salat. You know, I've read a nice article or statement by one of the mashayikh, Sheikh Fawaz al-Madkhali, hafidha Allah ta'ala. He said online, many people say, my wish and my hope to pray in Masjid al-Aqsa. My wish, that's what they say online, the Muslims, eh? My wish. But the same person who he wishes to pray in Masjid al-Aqsa, he doesn't even pray. He doesn't even pray. Look to this deception of shaitan. Brother, just pray to the masjid, pray in the masjid next to your house first. You see? Why? He just wants to show that he cares about Masjid al-Aqsa. And this is, As they say, "Ash-shay'u bi-shay'i yuzkar." Allah will not give us victory with this fake iman. No, Allah give victory with the iman that is based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah gave victory to Sahaba, not because they were sitting at home just having wishes, because they implement the deen of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So my dear brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all. This dunya, wal-iyadu billah, كثرت فيها خاصة الآن الفتن والمحن والبلايا والرزايا والخزايا والعياذ بالله. In our time, lot of trials and tribulations, a lot of fitan والعياذ بالله. And as we have mentioned, there is no safety and salvation except by going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the meaning of the verse. Say, O my servants, don't despair from Allah's mercy. O my servants who have transgressed against themselves, don't despair from Allah's mercy. Indeed, O verily, Allah forgive all the sins. But, anibu ila rabbikum, turn back to your Lord and submit to Him. Turn back to your Lord and submit to Him. So, Nabi, one of the scholars mentioned, or Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Al-Dhakirullah, the one who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and who the world doesn't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like the dead and the life. How many people you see them walking, laughing, joking, but in the reality they are dead? How many people, they're dead, they have passed away, but they're still alive with us? Al-Ulama, subhanallah. So, لأن حياة القلب هي الأصل. Because the life of the heart is the foundation. Ibn Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, categorized, as I have mentioned in his kitab, إغاثة اللهفان من مصائد الشيطان. he categorized the hearts, said this, three types of hearts. القلب السليم والقلب المريض والقلب الميت. The heart that is sound. And he goes on to describe what is the heart that is sound. The heart that is free from evil desires and doubts and misconceptions. And the hearts, and this heart submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follows النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. سمعنا وأطعنا. They say we hear and obey. And the قلب that is مريض, he has two elements. That is, the heart that is sick, he has two elements. One element pulling this heart to the evil side, to the dunya, and it's evil. And one the other element pulling the heart to Allah and the last day. And the قلب الميت والعياذ بالله, the heart that is dead, that doesn't recognize its Lord, doesn't understand its purpose, doesn't differentiate between good and evil. وَالْعِيَّادُ بِاللَّهِ. So my dear brothers and my sisters, how can we bring our hearts back to life? Is by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the remembrance of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. What the ulama mentioned, he said, you have the adu, you have the enemy coming after you to kill you. So what you do, you go inside the fortress to protect yourself against your enemy. He said, the dhikr of Allah is like the fortress. And your enemy is the shaitan. And he's coming after you to harm you and destroy you. So what you have to do to protect yourself is by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that includes what? Qira'at al-Qur'an, as-salat, the prayer, tayyib, fasting, night prayer, as-salat wa ma'adraka as-salat, tawheed, as-al-usul, the most important thing, which is tawheed, understanding Allah's right over us subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the tools how to protect ourselves from the fitna of this life and the evil of this life and the hereafter. Like through the Quran and the Sunnah. Through the Quran and the Sunnah al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. So my dear brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all. This dunya as a Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam described to us, Bani Adam, Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, An-Nasih al-Amin, the best advisor, the most sincere advisor is Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. He draws a circle. Then he draws a line that cross from one side to the other side of the circle. He said the circle is the human's life, our lives. And the line is our wishes, our hopes. You know, that what we want from the dunya, our desires. So our desires, our wishes is longer than our lives. How many of us, or how many people that we knew that have passed away and they had many wishes and they never made it? Subhanallah. That's why Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam used to say, Allahumma la taj'al ad-dunya akbar hammina ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. Oh Allah, do not make the dunya our main concern. Do not make the dunya our main concern. My brothers and my sisters, how many people used to come to the masjid strong, coming to study and seek knowledge? Then they went out to seek provision. They never came back. Dunya took them away. They had a long beard, then you see them, their beard is getting smaller and smaller. Then they say there's different opinions, but are you doing it because there's different opinions? You have to be honest to yourself, because no, you're not gonna affect no one except your heart and yourself. If you're doing it because your iman is going down, then all of us need to hurry to fix our iman. Then you see a brother used to have his qamis or his garments above his ankle. Then you see him musbil. He says, no, there's some aqwal of al-ilm, even his batil. Tayyib. But for the sake of arguments, are you doing it because you believe that qawl is valid based upon the Quran and the Sunnah? Or are you doing it because your iman is going low? Likewise, sisters with jilbab, they start taking off jilbab. And you ask them, you say, ya akhi, you know, I have to work. So the dunya became what? Our main concern. The dunya that we're going to leave. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he has a beautiful speech. He said, how many people know that this dunya, they're going to leave this dunya very soon. And this dunya have destroyed many people before them. Yet, they get deceived by the same dunya, which they knew that this dunya, which they knew, it destroyed many people before them. He said, what is very amazing about this dunya, you know, it's going to destroy you if you follow it, but you still follow it. Subhanallah. And in order for us to save ourselves, is about why? How do we save ourselves? Fafirru ila Allah. Flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a beautiful life when you flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama said, anything that you're scared of, you run away from it, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you know there's no salvation, and there is no protection, and there is no safety except by going back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, how many people left this dunya and they never entered to the Jannah? He said, what is the Jannah of this dunya? He said, ta'at al-Rahman, obedience of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wallahi, my young brothers, mashallah of young brothers here, you know, you have your friends maybe doing haram. Don't think you're missing out. Wallahi, you're not missing out. Nothing. Wallahi, as I say, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا يُنَبِّئُكَ مِثْلُ خَبِيرٌ. If you wanted to ask about the reality of that lifestyle, ask people who are well acquainted with it. That lifestyle is a humiliation. The life of disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is humiliation. Sadness, stress, depression, fear. أعوذ بالله من ذلك. You know, subhanallah, people that own, may Allah guide the Muslims who are upon haram, but if you go and ask them, they always will say to you, I want to be like you practicing. They will never say, I want to be all my life smoking drugs, selling drugs, doing haram. Subhanallah, ni'mah is a blessing to be upon ta'at al-Rahman tabaraka wa ta'ala. Imam bin Baz rahimahullah ta'ala, he used to always say, how many people left their houses, they never come back. How many people won't sleep, they never wake up. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called this dunya al-ghurur, deception. Deceived many people. Subhanallah. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. The hereafter is everlasting. It's better, not just better, and everlasting. Forever. It's forever. Subhanallah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when he described Jannah, he said, what the eyes never seen, what the heart never thought of, and what the ears never heard of about this, about the Jannah. Ala inna sal'ata Allahi ghaliya. Ala inna sal'ata Allahi al-Jannah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam used to say to his companions, verily Allah's products is so valuable. And what is Allah's product? Is Jannah. And the biggest and the greatest blessing to see Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahman, Al-Malik Al-Quddus, Al-Azizu, Al-Salam, Al-Wahid Al-Ahad, Al-Jabbar Al-Mutakabbir, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, as been mentioned in the narrations, that the biggest reward the believers will receive in Jannah to see Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, the way you be standing in the prayer, the way you're going to stand before Allah on the day of judgment. So choose how you want to stand before Allah on the day of judgment. Subhanallah. How many of us, when you pray too quick, subhanAllah, it's like you're standing before someone that you hate, you don't like. You just want to get rid of the prayer and leave. And now people, when they start feeling depressed, feeling down, anxiety, say, I want to go to psychologist, psychotherapist. Huh? SubhanAllah. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam used to say to Bilal, arihna biha ya Bilal. Make us relax with the prayer. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when he used to feel down, what he used to do? He used to pray. Salat. Standing before Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You are standing before Allah the Almighty. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, what is it? Fafirru ila Allah. You know, all these problems of the dunya, mashakil, troubles. And when you come to the masjid and you stand before Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and you pray, when you make sujood, you feel like burden came off of your, from your back. There was something like something heavy on your back, subhanAllah. Salat is the connection between us and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And I will highly recommend, my dear brothers and sisters, purchase the book of Imam Ibn Qayyim, Asrar al-Salat, the inner dimensions of the prayer. If you don't have it, buy it. And if you have it and you haven't read it, read it. When you're in the sujood, a man came to one of the servants of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, oh, he used to serve Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So once he came, he brought some water for the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to make wudu. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, also wants to ask something for me. Ask. And bear in mind, this person was poor. This Sahabi was poor, faqir. Al-Sofa. Al-Sofa is a group of Sahaba that were known to be fuqara, poor. Like, imagine you're poor and Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is asking you, ask something. Like, you want me to make dua to Allah? Ask. You're going to think, what about dunya? Subhanallah. But look at the Sahaba. That's why Sahaba, they were on a different level. The Sahabi is poor, and his Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is asking him, he's telling him, ask something for me, I will make dua to Allah. What did he say? He said, oh Messenger of Allah, I want to be with you in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. But faqir, poor, he's poor. He's faqir. If it was me, subhanallah, it's like subhanallah, dunya. How many people say, Akhi, I want to make money? Yeah, no one says don't make money. No one says stay in the masjid 24/7. Na'am, go seek risk, provision. But if you know you work, it's turning you away from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, then as Ibn Qayyim said, you'll be resurrected with Qarun. Because his wealth turned him away from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wealth that turned you away from Allah and cause your iman to go down, this is not the job you want to do. The friends that is they are turning you from Allah and causing your iman to go down, that's not the friends you are looking for and you want to be with. But look at the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. What did he say to the Sahabi? He said, then upon you, sujood, mean increase salat, prayer. The prayer, subhanAllah. See our brother and sister Malagai, them protesting. They want to help Palestine. Free mixing, dancing. That's not how I have Palestine. And we ask Allah to aid our brothers and sisters in Palestine, in Gaza, because they have been oppressed. SubhanAllah, these evil terrorists are killing them. No mercy. May Allah protect them. And may Allah accept those who have passed away as a martyrs. Wa ila Allah al-mushtaka, and we complain our situation only to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, in tansurullah yansuruk. If you give victory to Allah, I'm going to give victory to Allah by going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by fleeing to Allah, not by protesting. If you see the videos with Iyadu Billah, free mixing, they dancing, they playing drums and dancing. They were happy. A'udhu billah. It's how you are Palestine. But when you tell them that, well, they say you against Palestine. Now we engage this evil act. So the shahid said, make sujood. My dear brothers and sisters, in a sujood, you are close to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. One of the salaf said, wallahi, even as a salt from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a sujood. Even for a salt, milh, have a milh, salt, that you put in food. Sahaba and the salaf used to ask Allah, oh Allah, give us salt. Us is like you know, in need of Allah, you make sujood. You know, I'm not sure even we say, Subhanallah Rabbi al-A'la three times. From the signs of the hour, as the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, people will start praying like the chicken when they start picking up the food. Too quick. How many you see in the masjid? The prayer is the connection. After the most important salat of the fourth prayer, قيام الليل كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. They used to sleep a little during the night because they used to pray. Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned, if you want to increase sincerity, then عليك بالأعمال في السر. Do the righteous actions in secret. قيام الليل وما أدراك ما قيام الليل. One of the Salaf, his wife, he couldn't sleep. So his wife says, why you cannot sleep? He said, I fear that the angel of death will come to visit me any time. So I cannot sleep. So what he used to do is to wake up and pray a night prayer. And the ulama mentioned his story, one of the Salaf was traveling. And so he had to sleep under a tree. Then he saw in a dream that he was sleeping on the top of a grave. And he saw that man in the dream. He said, may Allah have mercy upon you. You sleeping on my grave. He said, how was the hereafter? He said, you know the two rak'ah that you prayed before you went to sleep? To me is more beloved than anything from this dunya. قال ربي ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا إيش فيما تركت. Say, my Lord, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, when a dev comes to one of them, he said, my Lord, turn me back. Perhaps I do what? A righteous action. Imam Ibn Uthaymeen, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, the person will never say, let me go back. Perhaps I play football. Let me go back. Perhaps I smoke drugs. Let me go back. Perhaps I do haram. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتْ. Perhaps I go back to righteous actions. Imam Ibn Uthaymeen said, that statement, that person is now, it's us now. So let us do righteous actions. Let us open a new page with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. The good deeds wipe away the evil deeds. All of us, we fall into mistakes. All of us, we fall into sins. All of us, we have shortcomings. But the problem is not you fall into sins. No, the problem when you choose to stay upon haram. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبَ أَوْ عَابِرُ سَبِيلٍ. Be in this life like a stranger or a wayfarer, a traveler. A wayfarer, a traveler. And he said this statement or this kalimat to the Sahabi Abdullah ibn Umar. And Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu arda used to say, إِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الْمَسَاءِ وَإِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحِ. If you wake up in the morning, don't expect to leave till the evening. And if you do leave until the evening, don't expect to leave till the morning. Always be ready and doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. This dunya is زائلة. You know, عند السوداني يقول لك يا زول. زول معناتها someone زائل, someone is going to disappear. That's what they call someone. Yeah, زول. زول means someone is going to disappear. This dunya, we're going to leave it. Either is going to leave us or we're going to leave it. So we have to prepare ourselves to meet Allah تبارك وتعالى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us what we need. فَتَزَوَّدُوا إِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. prepare yourselves, have provision for the hereafter, and the best provision for the hereafter is piety and righteousness. Piety and righteousness, not your wealth. Now you'll be asked by your wealth, but not your qualification, not your work, not about your football team that you support. It's about going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my dear brothers and sisters, some people that have relationship with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is like a boss and a servant. How? I'm going to work for you, but you have to pay me. That's how it is. So he's worshipping Allah, but in order to worship Allah, you have to be good to me. If anything bad happened to me, no, I become kafir, iyadu billah. That's why atheism, it boils down to emotional factors. You know, my mother passed away when I was young. I can't believe in God. My father passed away when I was young. I lost my girlfriend. That's why I cannot believe in God. He's drugged. Subhanallah. See, subhanallah. So he's thinking he has a relationship with Allah as a contract. I'm going to pray, but you have to give me only good. And some people that have a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't understand it, like Sophia, basically. They focus only on spiritual things. But Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's our creator and we are His servants. He's our master. He's our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we pray to Him, we're not commanding Him. When we ask Him, we're not commanding Him. We are begging Him. And it's up to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give us or not. Because it's Al-Hakim Al-Alim. This is His creation subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, my dear brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all. Alhamdulillah, the ni'mah of Islam, it has a solution for every problem. Every problem. You know, when you study about the psychology from the Western world, Sigmund Freud, or the other person, Clark, one of his colleagues, and the other ones, they want to bring happiness. Aristotle before that, what is happiness to them? They say happiness to be rich, happiness to have a nice wife, happiness to have a nice house, happiness to be connected to the creation. But alhamdulillah, we know what is happiness. Happiness is when you understand your purpose and you know Allah is your Lord and you should worship Him alone and follow the teaching of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah told us the true happiness, that when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how many people are looking for happiness in doing haram, smoking drugs? Do you remember there was a young girl a few years back? She was the richest young girl in the world, from USA. So she was not happy. She was very sad, even though she had ridiculous money. She went and got married to a person from Russia, and they lived in the mountain. Then she was not happy. Then she committed suicide. Subhanallah. You know the example I always give. If I say to you, go get ice cream, where are you going to find it? In the freezer, not in the microwave. If you keep going to microwave, you will never find ice cream there. The ice cream is in the freezer. Allah told us where the happiness is by way of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some of us, Allah al-Musta'an, we are looking for happiness, but we're in the wrong places. And believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in the qada wal qadar, when you turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, understand, when you flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you understand tawheed al-rububiyyah, you understand tawheed al-uluhiyyah, you understand tawheed asma wa sifat, and you know whatever has occurred or whatever will occur in this within Allah's creation is by Allah's permission. So you have the nafs al-mutma'innah, you have that soul, the nafs, which nafs mutma'innah, tranquility, كوز هذه النفس المطمئنه عندها هذه النفس اللوامه عندها هذه النفس ايش الاماره بالسوء but all of them is one نفس as Ibn al-Qayyim said it has different attributes it has different attributes اللوامه that blames you when you do haram الاماره بالسوء that pushes you to evil مطمئنه to have that نفس المطمئنه is by and worshiping Allah تبارك وتعالى like we mentioned look النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said نعم العبد عبد الله عمرو بن العاص لو كان يقوم من الليل what a servant is عبد الله بن عمر عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص if he only prays the night prayer الحمد لله my dear brothers and my sisters now literally first prayer comes in 4:45 عيشة is 8:15 even if you sleep let us say you're going to sleep 10-11 you still have enough time to sleep and wake up and pray night prayer Sheikh Fawzan said even 2 rak'at you know that iman you have that feeling when you pray the night prayer so don't be deceived my dear brothers and sisters with this dunya And my advice to you, read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, read the works and the books of Ibn al-Qayyim, Ighathatul Lahfan, Al-Da'u wal-Dawa', Ibn Rajab, Qaswat al-Qalb, Ibn al-Jawzi, the disturbers of the heart. We need these books in our library. We need reminders Brothers, can you come forward, Barakallahu Fikum? Well, make space for the people outside. The brother just corrected me. It was Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab. Nawarda, barakallahu feekum. So my brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you. As I was mentioning the book that we should have, the Disturbance of the Heart, Journey to Allah by Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, rahimahu ta'ala. So Journey to Allah, this book is good for the heart, for our soul, rectifying our hearts. And of course, the Quran, the book of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Reading the stories of the prophets and messengers. Qasatul Anbiya. Quran, read Surat Qaf. Read Surat Noon. Read Surat Al-Dhariyat. Read Surat Al-Waqi'a. Read Surat Amma Yatasa'alun. An Al-Naba'il Azim. Alladhi hum fihi ukhtalifun. كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون How many of us we spend hours just flicking through our phones but do ask ourselves be honest to ourselves يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وآليكم نارا But you serve first ourselves. What is causing my iman to go down? Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu wa ardhah said, "Min hikmati rajul," from the wisdom of the person to know what is causing his iman to go down, to abstain away from it. Especially my young brothers and sisters with social media. Ajaib, nas Allah salama wa al-afiyah. Fitan coming to our own houses, in our rooms. Subhanallah, now even in your own room you can be free mixing, doing haram. May Allah protect us. So we need to flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we need to open a new page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there's nothing better than worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a beautiful life when you are upon istiqamah, uprightness, salat, coming to the masjid. Make sure, try your best to pray 5 times a day in the masjid. Try your best. Don't say, "I cannot hear the mu'addin." Some scholars differ. Wallahi, my dear brothers and sisters, sometimes some people are using different opinions of the scholars to follow their desires. Barakallahu fik. To follow their desires. And may Allah save us all. No one is safe from it, including myself. Going to, which one is better? Praying, okay, there's different opinions. If you have, but ahsan to pray in the masjid, akhi. You get better reward. Fajr prayer in the masjid. What a beautiful, Allah Akbar. The feeling. As Hassan Basri said, he said, if the kings and their children knows the life we live in, they will fight us for it with their swords. When Umar ibn Khattab entered upon the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, his room way smaller than this. You know, some sisters, may Allah guide us and guide them. They said, "I can't stay in a house." If you know where Aisha used to live, and Zainab, and Kulthum, and Hafsa, they lived in a small room. And Allah said, "Qanna fi buyutikunna." Stay in your houses. Of course, if you have to go out, of necessity, go out. But Nabi alayhi salam was laying down on his mat. Ibn Khattab entered upon the Nabi alayhi salam. And he saw nothing in the house of Nabi alayhi salam. Ibn Khattab started crying. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, Kisra and Herakl." Kisra was the king of the Persian, and Heraclius. They're kuffar and they have dunya palaces and everything. He said, "Ya Umar, ala tarda an takuna lahum ad-dunya wa lana al-akhirah?" He said, "Ya Umar, are you not pleased? They have this life and we have the hereafter." That doesn't mean we should not work or participate in the dunya. But what it means, as the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned the hadith, whoever wakes up in the morning and his main concern is the dunya, Allah will scatter his affairs and he put poverty between his eyes and he will not receive from this dunya except what Allah has written for him. How many of us, we miss salawat in the masjid, or we miss salat on time and nothing moved us? It's like nothing happened. And if we lose 10 pounds, we go crazy about it. We go majnoon about it. One of the Salaf came to the masjid and he missed jama'ah, not the prayer on time. He missed jama'ah. He starts crying and his student said, "What's wrong here, Sheikh?" He starts saying, "La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah." This musiba, calamity, he said. Calamity, what is it? He missed jama'ah. That's why our heart is Allah al-mushtaka. But we have to. We can't be like them. They're on different levels. But we have to strive. Strive, because the akhirah is our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes on to say, and whoever wakes up in the morning and his main concern is the akhirah, the hereafter, Allah will rectify his affairs and Allah will put richness in his heart, contentment, you know, al-qana'ah, he's content. Even as a little, but he's content, as he's the richest person in the world. Subhanallah. So because why his main concern is, and Allah will bring the dunya to him, Allah will drag the dunya to him. Subhanallah. Some of us, we miss salawat when we say, Akhi, why don't you pray? Well, Akhi, in my work, I can't pray. I have to work. Subhanallah. So you prefer you work over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That goes back to deficiency of your iman of rububiyyah. Because a risk, Allah gives a risk even to the kafir. Because he comes under rububiyyah. And Allah rub everyone subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to check your heart. Go, when you go to work, yes, I'm going to work. I'm going to join your job. But I have condition. I'm a Muslim. I need to pray. I know you can't take care of yourself. You know the Razzaq. Allah is the Razzaq. Allah is the provider. Not you. If I know you are the provider, I worship you. But I know Allah is the Razzaq. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man taraka shay'an lillah, awadahu khayran minhu." Whoever leaves something for the sake of Allah, Allah will give him something better than it. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, if you really, really put trust in Allah, then Allah will provide for you like the birds. They go out in the morning with the empty bellies, stomach. They come back with full stomach. Like, oh, sometimes I'm eating and I have food left. So yeah, the birds, the pigeons in the park, I go and give them the food. Subhanallah. No, they go out for food. I'm coming to give them the food. Allah bringing provision to them. Subhanallah. So, risk, Allah is the Razzaq. Now, you take the asbab. You take the asbab. That's why when you look to going back to psychology and to the, what they call it, how the kuffar deal with it, they come from purely material point of view. Tayyib? And they want to give solution. So what they end up doing? Causing more problems. It's about yourself, individualism. Now think about yourself. It's about you. Tayyib, Islam comes in, no? Na'am, if you feel sad, someone caused harm to you, forgive. Huh? Subhanallah. Islam, problem, there's a solution. Something bad happened to you, the qada' wal qadr. Remember Allah's decree. Everything happened by Allah's permission. He gives you what? Tuma'nina. Subhanallah. So they try to help people. We can only get everything they say. Some stuff which is true. But because they don't have the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they fall short in many things. So us, what we need, the Muslims, like subhanallah, they are the psychologists, psychiatrists, psychotherapists. And what happened? A lot of depression, a lot of stress. So what are the psychiatrists doing? Psychologists, they are themselves mentally unwell as well. They don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you help me? Yourself, you have a big problem. You don't even believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. How are you going to help mankind? So how are you going to people to help you? They need help. Go back to Quran and Sunnah. And some people say, I tried to read the Quran. Yeah, you were reading like a newspaper, that's why. How if Allah said shifa, cure from what? From anything. Some people, they think Quran only cure for spiritual thing, only jinn. I have jinn problem. Read the Quran to me. No, Quran is cure. You have headache, read the Quran yourself. You have pain in your back, read the Quran on yourself. That doesn't mean you don't take the asbab, the other asbab, but the Quran is sabab too. But everything is what? Works by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ad'iyah. So, high rate of divorce. Didn't happen, people. Because why? It's about you. Your husband, what do you call it, broke your heart. Leave him. It's about you. Focus about yourself. Your wife did something bad to you. Forget her about yourself. You go back to Quran and Sunnah. Go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Alhamdulillah, it is time for us, if we are still doing haram, to stop. Because anytime we can leave this life, and when you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقَّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِنْ هَذَا فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. When the intoxication of death comes with the truth, this is why you try to avoid. And today, your sight is sharp because you see the edge of death. You see what Allah mentioned. It is the truth. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us husn al-khatima. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to aid us to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my advice to my dear brothers and sisters, to be upon uprightness, istiqama, is upon you to have a good friends. Have good friends. It's very important to help you. People that love you for the sake of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, they will help you to be upon istiqama, because they will check on you. And to be upon the correct istiqama, alayna bil ilm, is upon us to seek knowledge, to study, to learn. Because how can you follow someone you don't know nothing about? As the Sheikh Salah Al-Fawzan mentioned, how can you worship Allah and you don't know nothing about Allah except Allah exists and you don't understand His name's attributes? So go back to Quran, read the Quran. Even one chapter a day. Even one chapter a day, my dear brothers and sisters. Wallah, if someone, imagine a king or someone that you highly respect and you love, you look up to, send you a letter, every day you're going to open it. See, let me read it. And you always feel happy. That is, imagine you get a message from what? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. As what the ulama said, if you want Allah to speak to you, read the Quran. And if you want to speak to Allah, dua and prayer. And before we finish, the brothers just asked me to mention, please mention the end about the donation for the masjid. We have made an offer for a new building and we are still about 1.5 million short. We need to make this, what is this about? Shortfall in about 6-8 months. It's very, very difficult task. But with the help of Allah first and yourselves, we can make it inshallah ta'ala. So alhamdulillah, we have here the machine. If you have a card, so help. Alhamdulillah, look, the masjid, mashallah, Dar Sunnah, we have every single day class. So we have tomorrow two classes. Alhamdulillah, Thadal Usul, Arabic class, Sunday, sisters class in the morning, then evening class, Kitab al-Tawheed, then Ighath al-Lahfan, Monday, Arabic class, Tuesday, Quran class, Wednesday, Mulakhas al-Fiqhi, Sheikh Salah Fawzan, Thursday, Usul Sunnah, Friday, lectures. Alhamdulillah. Even a small place, but alhamdulillah, try our best to help our community. Because that's how we keep people busy with ilm. Alhamdulillah. And we're trying to do activities for the brothers and sisters to help our young brothers and our young sisters stay away from the road. Inshallah ta'ala. Even we don't have a lot of capacity, but we try our best to help the community, alhamdulillah. And this is the beauty of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They don't busy the youth with Daoush beyond their capacity. They will visit them with Daoush, will benefit them in this life and the hereafter. With the Quran, the Sunnah, Tawheed, Aqeedah, Fiqh, Arabic, Quran. Barakallahu feekum. Jazakum Allah khair. If there's any correction or question, you're more than welcome, inshallah, before we finish.
What was the fourth site you mentioned, the four reasons Allah created us? What was the fourth one?
The wisdoms. Yeah, we said there to worship Him, to implement His attributes, and to test, and to recognize one another.
Can you go into detail of that one?
To recognize, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, خلقناكم شعوبا وقبائل تعارفوا. We create you in tribes, create you in tribes and شعوبا and nations in order for you to know one another, like to help, you know, to recognize, helping. Yes.
Jazakallah.
Barakallah feekum.
You know, you said the statement, if the kings and their sons knew what we had,
Ibn Adam, Hassan Basri as well. Yeah, yeah. So he's been mentioned by a few from the Salaf. Hassan Basri, Ibn Adham. Yeah. That doesn't mean there's some kings that were upon Ta'at al-Rahman as well. But generally speaking. And you know, subhanAllah, Hassan Basri has a beautiful speech. He said, Allah has written humiliation upon those who disobey Him. Even if they have nice garments, big smile on their faces, but deep down, depression and stress. It's true. SubhanAllah. It's true. SubhanAllah. They say the most happiest countries in the world is Japan and Sweden, yes? The highest rate of suicide, where? In Japan and Sweden. I don't know how they're happy. I'm so happy I'm going to kill myself. A'udhu billah min dhalik. A'udhu billah min dhalik. You see, because why? They don't know what is happiness. Do you know how they define happiness? Because they get good wage and they have good houses. That's not happiness. Happiness is Ta'at al-Rahman. SubhanAllah. Look how Islam is spreading in the Western world. Because they knew. Look, especially there's a huge war against Islam. More specifically, they say Islam oppressed women. Sahih? Say Islam oppressed women. Majority of reverts are women. And they done research. These women that becoming Muslims, they study for 5 years before accepting Islam. Because the real meaning of freedom, when you become a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you become a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the worst type of slavery, when you are a slave of your desires and society. This is the worst type of slavery. Imam Abdul Hamid bin Badis, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, how many men is free, but in reality is a worse slave? Why? Because he's been enslaved mentally. When you are enslaved mentally, you are the worst slave. You're just following your desires, like sheep. SubhanAllah. And you know, when you flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't become like sheep. Because your criteria is the Quran, the Sunnah. Your criteria is no majority. This is a criteria. The Quran and the Sunnah. Not everyone's doing it. I'm going to do it. Look to Prophet Lut alayhi salam. Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam. They just follow their people because they were doing haram. The last of them, Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. When you said to some people, Akhi, why are you doing haram? Everyone's doing it. So are you sheep? Everyone's doing it. That's not a justification. SubhanAllah. So when you flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you are young in age, Allah give you insight to see the reality of these fake slogans. You will not be deceived. Freedom. Enjoy your life. SubhanAllah. You know, what do you mean by enjoy your life? Alhamdulillah, Islam tells us to enjoy our life. You mean smoking drugs, right? That's not the meaning of enjoy my life. I'm hurting my life. I'm harming my life. SubhanAllah. So Allah, my dear brothers and sisters, all of us, we need to strive Because based upon my own experience, which is a little, we've been in this masjid since 2009. How many people came and they just, subhanAllah, stopped practicing completely? They went out for the dunya, they never come back, subhanAllah. And we ask Allah to guide them and to protect them. You know, because when the dunya become your main concern, Allah, subhanAllah, it's a calamity. Even if you work full time, try your best to pray even one prayer in the masjid. Isha, try your best. Try your best. Imam al-Dhahabi, he has a nice risale advising his students. He said, how can you be a student of knowledge when you don't even pray in the masjid? When you don't pray in the masjid? How can you claim that? Subhanallah. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, when someone came to visit him, he left the water for him to pray night prayer. When he came back, he said the water the same the way he left it. He found the water the same, he left it. He said, don't pray night prayer. He said, لا ينبغي لطالب علم أن لا يقوم من الليل شيء. It's not befitting for a student of knowledge to not pray even a small amount of night prayer. It's not befitting. Subhanallah. Before the Salaf in everything. Dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar. Huh? Likewise, Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh mentioned a beautiful statement. I will finish with it. He said, Salamatul Qalb. Your heart should be, you have no grudge against your Muslim brothers and sisters. Forgive. Overlook. Do you remember the story when Nabi was sitting down with his companions? He said, someone is going to enter upon us and his people from the people of Jannah. So one Sahabi entered. So Abdullah ibn Abdul Aziz followed him to his house. And he said, I want to stay with you because I had issues with my father. So he stayed with him. He said, so he said for 3 nights. He said, you know, Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, you are a person of Jannah, from the people of Jannah. But I've noticed you don't do much. He said, yes, I pray the 5 daily prayers. He said, what I do before I go sleep, I forgive my Muslim brothers and sisters. And I have no grudge against my Muslim brothers and sisters. He said, that's why you pass us. And this is the hardest thing to do. To forgive and to not hold a grudge against someone who oppressed you or against the Muslim brothers and sisters. Salamatul Qalb. We ask Allah to give us Salamatul Qalb. Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifun. Wassalamu ala al-Mursalin. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, we're going to be having food later after Isha prayer. So, inshallah, stick around, yeah? For the food, inshallah. Barakallahu fiqh. Let's end it off. Barakallahu fiqh.